Good day, students. Today we continue our discussion on the chemistry of sulfur and its compounds. In our last section, we x-rayed sulfur as elements. We looked at occurrence of sulfur. We also looked at the extraction of sulfur and the allotropes of sulfur. In this section, we are going to examine one, preparation and properties of allotropes of sulfur, two, physical properties of sulfur, three, chemical properties of sulfur. Let's start with the first concept, which is those preparation and properties of allotropes of sulfur. For the purpose of a reminder, we know that we have three allotropes of sulfur. We have the rhombic sulfur, also known as alpha sulfur. We have monoclinic sulfur. Also known as beta sulfur. And we have the third one, which is plastic sulfur. Both rhombic and monoclinic sulfur form the crystalline allotropes of sulfur, while plastic form the amorphous allotrope of sulfur. So let's look at the preparation of the first one, which is rhombic. Preparation of rhombic sulfur. Preparation. Rhombic sulfur can be obtained by dissolving rose sulfur. Rose sulfur is sulfur obtained from a fresh process in a liquid substance known as the carbon 4 sulfide. That's CS2, carbon 4 sulfide. The solution is allowed to evaporate and that will produce a yellow transparent solid, which is a rhombic sulfur. Now, what are the properties of rhombic sulfur? Properties of rhombic sulfur. One, rhombic sulfur is stable at ordinary temperature. It is stable at ordinary temperature. That's temperature below 96 degrees Celsius. Number two, it is yellow in color. It is yellow, pale yellow in color. That is light. That's number six. Number three, it is soluble in carbon 4 sulfide. That's the CS2. Then number four, it contains S8 molecule. That is, it has a ring that has sulfur atom. If you look at the body, this S8 molecule of what of sulfur. If you count number of sulfur atoms you have, it's going to be 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this S8 molecule of sulfur. The other property is that it is octahedra in shape. This is rhombic sulfur. Look at the shape. It's octahedra in shape. Octahedra in shape. Now let's move to the second one, which is monoclinic sulfur. Preparation and properties of monoclinic sulfur. Preparation. Monoclinic sulfur can be prepared by dissolving rose sulfur in a solution known as methyl benzene. Methyl benzene. We also call it toluene. So when we dissolve crude sulfur in this solution, we are going to have what? A monoclinic sulfur. It is formed when we warm the solution and we allow it to. We discover that at the side of the beaker, when you have the solution, you are going to have what? A needle-like transparent yellow crystals to be formed. And that yellowish transparent crystal is what is a monoclinic sulfur. So what are the properties of monoclinic sulfur? Properties. Number one, it is stable at temperature above negative degrees Celsius. Stable at temperature above 96 degrees Celsius. Number two, it is needle-like in shape. Look at the shape there. You can see it's needle form. So this is monoclinic what monoclinic sulfur is. It's needle-like in shape. The other property is that it is soluble. It is soluble in carbon 4 sulfide, that's CS2. Then it is amber is what, that's deep yellow in color. Number five, it has melting points. Melting point of 119 degrees Celsius. Then number six, it is transparent to light. So these are some of the properties of monoclinic sulfur. So let's look at the third one, which is the amorphous form. That is what? Plastic sulfur. Plastic sulfur. Preparation. It can be prepared by pouring molten rose sulfur in cold water continuously. When you pour molten rose sulfur continuously in cold water, you are going to have what? A non-crystalline elastic substance, which is a plastic sulfur. And what are the properties? Properties? The first one, it is soft and elastic. Soft and elastic. Two, it is partially soluble in carbon 4 sulfide, that's CS2. Number three, it is unstable. Yes, unstable. That means it can revert back to what? Back to aerobic sulfur. If you allow it to stand, that means it has, it is what is unstable. Let's move to the next content, which is the physical properties of sulfur. Physical properties of sulfur. Physical properties of sulfur. Number one, sulfur is a yellow non-metallic solid. Sulfur is the yellow non-metallic solid. Two, sulfur exhibits allotropy. 3, sulfur has a melting point of 120 degrees Celsius and a boiling point of 444 degrees Celsius. Then number 4, sulfur is a bad conductor of heat and electricity. Let us stop here for now. But before that, take this question as assignment. Let me just give one question. Assignment. One assignment. Give. 3 differences and 3 similarities between rhombic and monoclinic sulfur. Thank you for watching. Take care and stay safe.